Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Monica Mehta from Satyavati College, University of Delhi. My today's lecture is on variational inequality problems defined in terms of bifunction. Let me first give you an overview of my lecture. We'll first of all introduce variational inequality problems in terms of bifunction. We'll study the conditions under which these problems have a solution and under what conditions these solutions become unique. We will also study the relationship of these variational inequality problems with optimization problems and then characterize the solution set of the problem. Equilibrium, as we know, is the key concept in many disciplines, be it economics, operation research, and engineering. Now, the various methodologies that have been used for the study of equilibrium problem includes system of equations, optimization theory, complementarity theory, fixed point theory. But variational inequality theory is a unifying methodology for the study of equilibrium problems, as variational inequality problem subsumes all these problems, be it a system of equations, optimization problem, fixed point problem. These are all particular cases of variational inequality problem. Now, variational inequality problem has its introduction. It was introduced in the year 1966 by Hartman and Stempakia, and it was used as a tool for the study of partial differential equation. Now, what exactly is a finite dimensional variational inequality problem? Now, this problem states that we need to find a vector x belonging to C such that the inner product of fx with y minus x is greater than or equal to 0 for every y in C, where f is a function from Rn to Rn and C is a non-empty closed convex subset of Rn. In other words, we need to find a vector x in C such that the vector fx makes an acute angle with all the vectors emanating from x. Now, the simplest example of variational inequality problem is this one. See, if we consider the optimization problem minimize fx subject to x belonging to ab. Now, this is our optimization problem where we are taking f to be a differentiable function from R to R. Now, suppose x star is the point of minimum of this problem. Now, in case x star is a point lying between a and b, then we know that f dash x star will be equal to 0. In case x star is equal to a, that is, this is the point of minima, so graph will be somewhat like this. And in this case, we will have f dash x star is greater than equal to 0. And if x star is equal to b, then f dash x star will be less than equal to 0. This means that the function will be a decreasing function, so the graph will be somewhat like this. Now, combining these three inequalities, we can write it as f dash x star, the product of f dash x star with x minus x star is greater than equal to 0. Now, if you compare this with the variational inequality problem we had just introduced, here capital F is nothing but f dash x star. So, this is nothing but an example of variational inequality problem in R. Now, if C is equal to Rn, and f is a function from Rn to Rn, then a vector x belonging to Rn will be a solution to SVIP if and only if fx is equal to 0. Now, let us have a look at the proof of this. See, if fx is equal to 0, then this inequality will automatically be satisfied. Inner product of 0 with any vector will be 0. Now, we have to take the case converse part when now we are assuming that x satisfies SVIP, that is, x is a solution of the variational inequality problem. Now, since x is a solution of variational inequality problem, this inequality is true for every y. So, in particular, if I take y to be x minus fx, what do I get? I get this inequality. which is nothing but minus norm of fx square greater than equal to 0. But since norm is always less than greater than equal to 0, and here this means that norm of fx square is less than equal to 0. So this implies that norm of fx is equal to 0, which implies that fx is equal to 0. Now, it is not necessary that the variational inequality problem will always possess a solution. A simple example to this is that if I take c to be r and fx to be this function e raised to power x, then the inequality e raised to power fx into y minus x, this becomes e raised to power x into y minus x, is greater than equal to 0 for all x belonging to c. So this inequality will never be satisfied. So this will never possess a solution. Now, but under what conditions does the problem SVIP possess a solution? It possesses a solution when f is continuous on C and the set C is compact. These two conditions ensure that the problem SVIP will at least have one solution. So these are the sufficient conditions for the existence of solution to the problem SVIP. Now next, consider the optimization problem: minimize fx subject to x belonging to C, where C is a convex set in Rn and f is a mapping from Rn to R. Now if f is a differentiable function and x is a solution to this problem P, then the necessary optimality condition for this problem is nothing but this inner product of gradient of fx with y minus x is greater than equal to 0 for all y belonging to C. Now, if you look at this and compare it with the problem SVIP, you'll see that this is nothing but of the form of the problem SVIP, where capital Fx is nothing but gradient of Fx. So necessary optimality conditions for this optimization problem, they are the form of a variational inequality problem. So now we come to the main topic of our lecture, that is variational inequality problems in terms of bifunction. Now, how do we define a variational inequality problem in terms of bifunction? It is defined as a vector x. We need to find a vector x in C such that this inequality is satisfied, that is hx y minus x is greater than equal to 0 for all y belonging to C, where h is a mapping from C cross Rn to R bar. R bar is nothing but R union plus minus infinity, and C is a closed convex subset of Rn. So we can see that if we take hx y minus x to be equal to this inner product fx y minus x, then the problem SVI actually reduces to the problem SVIP. Now, under what conditions the problem SVI possesses a solution? Now, these are the set of sufficient conditions. First of all, C should be a non-empty compact convex subset of Rn. Second, H should be continuous in both the arguments. This bifunction H should satisfy this condition inequality. Hx0 should be greater than equal to 0. And the mapping Y from Y to Hx Y minus X, this should be convex on C. So under these conditions, under these assumptions, the problem SVI will possess a solution. Now, in case C is not the bounded set, closeness we are taking, but if we are assuming that C is not bounded, in that case, we have an additional condition that there exists a non-empty compact convex subset D contained in C, such that for every x outside D, that is every x in the complement of D, there exists some y in D, such that this condition is satisfied, hx y minus x is less than 0. Then again, the problem SVI will possess a solution. Now, let us take an example. Let C be the closed interval minus 2 to 3 and H be a bifunction defined like this. Hx is equal to x square plus g. Now, here we can see that H is continuous in both the arguments. Hx0, which is x square, is greater than equal to 0. The mapping from y to hx y minus x. This is gy, which is defined as hx y minus x. This becomes this function. It's a convex function, and it possesses this problem. SVI will possess a solution, and its solution set is given by this -2 to -1 union 2, 3. Now let's explore under what condition the problem SVI will have a unique solution. For that, we need the concept of pseudo-monotonicity. Now, what is this concept? See, a bifunction H is said to be pseudo-monotone on C if whenever hx y minus x greater than equal to 0 implies hy x minus y is less than equal to 0. And it is said to be strictly pseudo-monotone if same condition, but this must imply that this inequality is satisfied strictly. That is, hy x minus y is strictly less than 0. Now, from the definitions itself, it is clear that every strictly pseudo-monotone function is pseudo-monotone. Now, if in addition to the previous conditions for existence, we have this condition that H is strictly pseudo-monotone, then the problem SVI will possess a unique solution. Dini derivatives, we all are familiar with. Here are the definitions of upper Dini derivative and lower Dini derivative. These are some of the properties of Dini derivatives, which we all know. Another concept that we need is that of pseudo-convexity. So we define a function f is said to be S pseudo-convex on C if whenever fy is less than fx implies hx y minus x is less than 0. Now here is an example of S pseudo-convex function. Now let us consider this optimization problem P. Minimize fx subject to x belonging to C. Now, if x bar is an optimal solution for this problem P and the bifunction h, it satisfies this condition, that is hx dot is always greater than equal to the lower Dini derivative, then x bar will be a solution of the variational inequality problem SVI. So if my bifunction h is chosen such that it is greater than equal to the lower Dini derivative, then x bar will also be a solution to the problem SVI. And the converse of this result, that is a solution of SVI, will be a solution to the optimization problem P if we assume that f is a h pseudo-convex function on C. Now here is an example to illustrate that the condition of h pseudo-convexity cannot be relaxed in the previous theorem. Now, fx I'm defining to be 1 if x is rational, -1 if x is irrational, and -1 if x is rational. Now, hxg we are taking to be the upper Dini derivative, which is coming out to be this. Then here we can see that this condition of S pseudo-convexity is not being satisfied for at the points this, x equal to root 2 and y equal to 1. Here fy is less than fx, but hx y minus x is coming out to be equal to 0 rather than less than 0. And we can note that every irrational number is a solution of SVI, but it is not a solution of the problem P. Now if we modify the above example and we take hxg to be equal to minus mod d if x is irrational and mod d if x is rational, then we can see that f is h pseudo-convex on R, and my hx dot, it is actually compressed between the upper and the lower Dini derivative, and in this case the solution sets of the problem SVI and P will coincide. Now here is another example to show that the condition hx dot greater than equal to d plus fx dot, this condition cannot be relaxed. So here is my function fx, this is what the lower Dini derivative is coming out to be. And if I choose my hxg to be this, then we see that hxg is strictly less than d plus fxg for the points when x is 0 and d is strictly positive. And we can also check that x equal to 0 is a solution of the problem P, but it is not a solution of the variational inequality problem SVI. I hope you people have enjoyed the lecture. Thank you so much.